Hello everyone, myself Dr.Sunildatta N. Kulkarni, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand, Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today I am going to deliver a video session on Numericals on Load Factors, Part 2. In our previous video session, we have seen how to find out the various types of load factors from the given data and how to plot the load curve and load distribution curve. At the end of this video session, the students will be able to find various parameters related to power plant performance. The contents of this video session are, we are going to solve two problems on various types of load factors and other parameters related to power plant performance. Now let us see the problem number one statement. A generation station has a maximum demand of 20 megawatt, a load factor of 60%, plant capacity factor of 48%, and plant use factor of 80%. So here we are given with the maximum load on the power station or generation station as 20 megawatt, and the various types of load factors are given like load factor of 60%, plant capacity 48%, and plant use factor of 80%. And we are going to find the daily energy produced, the reserve capacity of the plant, the number of operating hours per day, and the maximum energy that could be produced daily if the generation station was running all the time, means if generating station runs all the time. Now let us see how to find out first of all the daily energy produced. Now we know that the load factor is given by an equation, average load upon maximum load. So load factor given in the numerical is 0.6, which will be equal to average load upon maximum load of 20 megawatt, which is given, and load factor is 60%, that is 0.6. So from this we can get the average load equal to 0.6 into 20 megawatt, which is equal to 12 megawatt. Now average load is nothing but the area under the load curve in kilowatt hour divided by number of hours for which the plant is in operation. From this, we can find the time for daily energy produced. Now we already know that the time for daily energy produced is 24 hours for a particular day. Then area under the load curve, which is nothing but the energy produced in kilowatt hour, that is number of units produced, which we can obtain from this equation as area under the load curve is nothing but energy produced, which will be equal to average load into number of hours. So this equation I have written, average load into number of hours. Now average load we have obtained as 12 megawatt, and the number of hours for which plant is operated throughout the day is 24. So from this we get that the total energy produced in a day is 288 megawatt hour, or 288 into 10 to the power 3 kilowatt hours number of units are being produced. Now let us see how to find out the reserve capacity of the plant. The plant capacity factor is nothing but the average demand upon installed capacity. We are given with plant capacity factor and we also know the average demand. So from this we can find out the installed capacity by rearranging this equation, as installed capacity will be equal to then average demand upon plant capacity factor, which we have taken from here to denominator. So we get installed capacity as average demand upon plant capacity factor. So now putting the value, average demand we have calculated as 12 megawatt divided by plant capacity factor given in the numerical is 0.48. So from this we will be able to get the installed capacity of 25 megawatt. But we know that the maximum demand already we know and installed capacity know. So reserve capacity will be equal to installed capacity minus maximum demand. The installed capacity is 25 megawatt minus maximum demand is 20 megawatt. So reserve capacity for the plant is 5 megawatt. Now let us see the number of operating hours per day. How to find out the number of operating hours for which the plant is operated? Now we know the equation, plant use factor is given by average demand into time divided by installed capacity into number of actual operating hours. So here, by putting the value of plant use factor as 0.8, average demand is 12 megawatt multiplied by 24 hours for a day, divided by installed capacity is 25 megawatt multiplied by number of operating hours. So by rearranging this equation, we will get the number of operating hours will be equal to 12 into 24 divided by 25 into 0.8. So number of operating hours, we get it as 14.4 hours. Now here we should understand that the plant is in operation only for 14.4 hours in a particular day. Now let us see what is the maximum energy that could be produced if the generation station was running all the time. The maximum energy that could be produced daily will be equal to installed capacity into 24 hours a day. So installed capacity is 25 megawatt multiplied by 24 hours. So we can obtain 600 megawatt hour per day if the plant is operated for 24 hours, or we can also write it as 600 into 1000 kilowatt hour, that is number of units, 600 into 1000 kilowatt hours, that is number of units, those can be produced. Now let us see the second numerical, that is problem number 2 statement. A 60 megawatt turbo generator set has an overall efficiency of 25%. The calorific value of coal usage is 24 megajoules per kg. Estimate the consumption of coal per kilowatt hour and also per day of 24 hours if the load factor is 30%. So important things to be noted are: the capacity of the turbo generator set is 60 megawatt, overall efficiency is 25%, coal calorific value given is 24 megajoules per kg. We want to find out coal consumption per kilowatt hour, per unit of electrical energy produced, and also per day of 24 if the load factor is 30%. Now let us see how we can find out, first of all, the consumption of coal per kilowatt hour. Now we know the equation in general, overall efficiency will be equal to output upon input. Now we want to find out the coal consumption per kilowatt hour. So therefore, what output we will consider? Let us think what can be the output that we should consider when we want to need to find out the coal consumption per kilowatt hour. So here we will take output as 1 kilowatt hour so that we can find out the input required from the equation of overall efficiency. So input power will be given by output power divided by overall efficiency. Output power given is taken is 1 kilowatt hour, which we have taken, divided by overall efficiency 0.25, we get input power as 4 kilowatt hour. Now let us see which we can write this 4 kilowatt hour into kilojoules. So 4 kilowatt hour we have expressed as 4 kilojoules per second multiplied by 1 hour equal to 3600 second, which comes out to be 14400 kilojoules. Now let us see how to find out then coal consumption per kilowatt hour. Heat required per kilowatt hour divided by calorific value of coal. Now heat required we have calculated earlier as, that is input power, as 14400 kilojoule divided by, this is the heat required per kilowatt hour, divided by calorific value of coal is 24,000 kilojoules per kg of coal. From this we get the coal consumption required is 0.6 kg per kilowatt hour, means for producing 1 unit of electricity we require 0.6 kg of coal. Now let us see. We know that the load factor is given by average load upon peak load. Therefore, average load will be equal to load factor into peak load. The load factor given is 0.3, whereas the peak load is 60. From this, we will be getting the average load of 18 megawatt. Now, for this, from this, we can find out the coal consumption per day. The energy generated in 24 hours will be equal to average load is 18. Multiplied by 24, which we get as 423 megawatt hour. And that in terms of kilowatt hour, when we multiply by 1000, we get 423,000 kilowatt hours. Now, for obtaining the coal consumption per day, we can write the equation as energy generated per day in kilowatt hour multiplied by coal required per kilowatt hour. Therefore, energy generated just now we have calculated at 423,000 kilowatt hour multiplied by coal required per kilowatt hour we have calculated in our step 1 as 0.6 kg per kilowatt hour. So, which comes out to be 259.2 tons. So, the coal consumed per day is 259.2 tons. These are the references. Thank you.